Father, I'm truly thankful for the love, the knowledge, the wisdom, and the courage. Hallowed be thy name, glory to the King, for keeping my soul so safe. God has a plan for every human or animal living on the earth. One of life great gifts God gave was a gift to create life. Bongile baba for loko uthando lakho nokungidala ngesifaniso sakho. Inhliziyo yami yonke impilo yami kusezandleni zomdali
wami. I think we can wrap it up here. I think one of the things that I like, you know, about this organization, this WIM, is that we always give everyone an opportunity to talk or to preach. And this is what we mean by an iron sharpens iron. By the way, my name is Tefo. You can call me Elder Tefo. Yeah. All right. I've been given an opportunity today to perhaps just wrap the message up with a word of encouragement. But after what you all have said, I've actually come to realization that there is not much of encouragement that I can do than what you've already done. I feel encouraged already. So I'll wrap the discussion just in 3 points. First of all, from my experience today, what I like is the faces that I saw in the morning when you come. You know, when you say, let us come, the word of God says in Hebrews 4:16, let us come boldly into the throne of grace, you know, that we may obtain mercy and find grace. So what I liked is the faces that I saw when you came in here, the boldness that I saw in here, that we are doing this. It's not just any other walk. It's a walk with God. And I think this is what I saw. This is what I realized when I came in here, that these are the guys that are seeking the face of God. It says also in I think, yeah, Khumutso was talking about it right now. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. You know, and the Bible says there, so for he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is the rewarder of them that seek him diligently. And how do you seek them diligently if you are not waking up in times like this, you know? So the way that you, if you know, the waking up so early and coming in at about 6 o'clock, seeking his face, trying to find yourself. Many of us are coming in here basically not exactly to find ourselves, you know, to come in and get to understand ourselves, but in us, deeper. The deepest issue is here is to find God himself. Hallelujah. So what I'll do is, gentlemen, I just want to, you know, I've summarized my message is just in just 3 points. And I've titled my message is Walking in the Light. I'm talking about walking in the light. If you look at those caps that you have in the light, is the message we received from the conference. Those of you who are joining us for the first time today, What is Man is an organization that is committed in restoring the legacy of manhood. And we have got conferences annually in the month of August, every last week of August, and we are meeting every Saturday, every first week of Saturday. We are meeting at number 2 Kings Road in Sandton, where we meet just for a little bit of prayer, a little bit of worship. Thereafter is sharing of experiences. All right, so we really like to invite all our first time visitors here today, and we'd like to come and join us in our walk. Amen. So I've looked at this when I was told that I can share a little bit or wrap up the message to say, what is it that I can talk about? And I decided, walking in the light. I believed that this is not just a hike. Maybe you're looking at this, you know, is this what kind of a hike is this? I mean, you are seeing people hiking for fitness, and we had an opportunity to ask them, what is it that you enjoy? I'm liking the nature. And some of you have said, I'm liking the nature. But, you know, what I'm realizing here is that this is not just a hike. And there was a reason why I'm saying that. I want you to study the word when you have a moment. There is a word shared in the book of Isaiah 43:19. Those of you who have a Bible, you can look at that. I looked at the message translation of that. It says, be alert, You know, there are other messages that says, behold, I am doing a new thing. But this one, he says, the message translation I read of, I read, it says, be alert, be present. I'm about to do something new. So in other words, not only be alert, be present, be alert, be present. The mistake that we can do today is to miss the whole point and take this as just a hike or just a walk for fitness. It's not like that. These guys, it says, be alert, be present. It is happening after 10 years of the existence of this organization. After 10 years, we get to come and have the word out in nature. We observe the tranquility. But more importantly, we are able to speak man to man, heart to heart. We get to the bottom of what the organization is all about. So here's my message here today, looking into this scripture. Be alert, be present. God is about to do something. I like it when it continues. It says, do you not see it? It's bursting out. Do you not see it? Other messages, other translations, it comes, it will come forth. It will spring forth. That's how God is so serious about us. It says, the Bible says, what is man that are mindful of, and the Son of Man that what is man that I am so mindful of, you know, and the Son of Man that have, you know, what does it say? Son of Man that is crowned with glory, all right? So, I visited him. So the Son of Man that he has visited, this visitation today, we're not taking it lightly as well. Amen. So that's just one scripture that I thought maybe, you know, it's important for us to look at for now. Be alert, be present, start. What is important here is that we are at a starting point. And those of the runners or those who are fit, who are able to go and check, maybe in Comrades Marathon, I was fortunate to have been part of it. You will realize when you observe that people are crying joy, tears of joy at the starting line. Because starting is not easy. To start, to just say, I'm joining this organization, I am making up my mind, I am moving, it's very difficult. So when they get to the starting line, they are more tearful, they have full of tears than they are at the end. Because when you are at the start, you are guaranteed that he who has begun the good thing in you will see you to the end. But how do you again go to the finish without starting? That is why I'm saying we are excited about the fact that we have started, we have taken the decision to start. My plea is, now that we have started, let's get more people, let's work with them. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The next point I want us to examine, to have a look at, I looked at the fact that when we came in here, Rajo, Anthony, they have prepared some bags for us, you know, and I looked at the scriptures. Wow, man, God works in a mysterious way. I was studying this scripture. I was studying Hebrews 12 in verse 1, you know, it's like, therefore we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us. And the leadership has decided, no guys, there are no weights that you're going to carry. You are carrying a bottle here, you are carrying a banana, you are carrying, so organized that we have these slim bags, we have them on us. So the same with our journey of life. What is it that you need to put down today? And I think, let us try and observe and check. He says, let us lay aside every weight and every sin that can easily ensnare us. I think let us take this opportunity and say, in our walk, in our hiking of some sort, in our walk with God, what are the weights that we are carrying unnecessarily? What are the worries? What are the fears that we are carrying unnecessarily? How can we take, what are the things that we need to take down for ourselves, you know? And I like what the scripture says is here. It says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. So as we run this race, And as we observe the hike today that we have observed, in fact, experienced, let me say so, as we take this experience and apply it as well, it is nice to see the tranquility, the flow of water. Water give meaning or give life to humanity, but it is the spirit that gives life to eternity. And it is for these reasons that we need to long to walk the journey with God, and we need to learn to understand the inner man that is in us. Hallelujah. So guys, this is my point here today. Let us examine our weights as we walk in the journey. Let us look into the things that we need to put down. And I like it as it continues, it says, and the sin which so easily beset us, which so easily ensnare us. So as men, we need to be wary of the sin that easily ensnare us. So in our walk with God, we need to walk away from the sin, like be intentional about the fact that I am resisting the devil, because the word of God resists the devil and he will flee. Hallelujah. So that's my second point to you. Let us examine our weight and let's make sure that we travel light. And how do we travel light? We cast our burdens to God. He says, cast your burdens to me, for I care for you. So let's make it a point, guys, that we cast our burdens to God. Only God knows. Only God is our creator. Only God knew us before we were formed. Hallelujah. And the last point I want us to examine, in the hustle and bustle of the city, we are fortunate to come out here and people are saying, yo, I was not even aware that I'm no longer in Joburg. What an atmosphere. What an observation of nature. The freshness that we're observing in here. It gets us to think differently and brings me to this point here. Let us go back to the basics. I want us, as I am concluding, to look into one scripture that is in Luke 16 and 19. The story is told of the rich man and Lazarus. I am sure some of you have gotten to know about that, but perhaps just as this is the last point, maybe to drive everything home, let's read that scripture. Let's just make sure that we are reading that scripture. I didn't have it here. I've got my Bible there. I'm not going to read it here. I just want to, Bravins, can you read it from me? 16:19. Luke 16:19. The rich man and Lazarus.
There was a certain rich man which was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fed sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was laid at his gate, full of sores, and desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died, and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. And in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torment, and seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me. Send Lazarus, that he may dip the tip of his finger in water, and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime receiveth thy good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things. But now he is comforted, and thou art tormented. And beside all this, between us and you, there is a great gulf fixed, so that they which would pass from hence to you cannot, neither can they pass to us that would come from thence.
Amen. Thank you, David. So this is what we read from the scripture, that a rich man was fed sumptuously every day. This was a person who was rich, and laid on his gate was Lazarus, who had sores The Bible says even dogs would lick the sores. So it says that Lazarus was waiting there to be fed with crumbs from the rich man. He was not looking for anything, just the crumbs from there. But I wanted to drive this message home today to say that we are caught up with the ambitions of this world and forget our missions. The rich man, he says that he was living in purple linen, fed sumptuously every day. But late at his gate was Lazarus. And perhaps this is the time that we need to also examine our life to say, what is it that is late at my gate? Perhaps as you go out of your gate coming here, you didn't even greet your neighbor, but you come in here for a good cause. But what is late at your gate? You have got maybe a child that is suffering, maybe your sisters or brothers, but you've got also an organization that you maybe are giving money to. What is late at your gate? And this is my question here, guys, to say, in the hustle and bustle of the city, it's very easy that we can go with the crowd and try to answer to the big cause, but we leave smaller things. God is judging the rich man with the least. In the book of Matthew 25, the disciples in the last, I think it's from 37, verse 37, they are asking Jesus, Jesus, when did we see you naked and did not clothe you? When did you see you hungry and fed you? When did you see you thirsty and give you water? And when did we see you, in prison and visited you? You know, you can read the scripture later when you have time, Matthew 25. And he answered and says, brethren, I tell you, inasmuch as you did this to the least of these, my brethren. So the rich man was judged by the least. He says, inasmuch as you did to the least of these, my brethren, you also did it to me. So what is Jesus expecting? He's expecting that we do good to the least. And we are focusing on the bigger project. And we are focusing on our bigger ambitions. And God is saying, like the rich man is doing, and perhaps this is the message we can take when we deciding on looking at our walk to God. What are the least things? What are the least things that are laid at my gate? Hallelujah. So I see some of the people trying to sleep, and I take it that is the message having driven home. And guys, thank you so much. I thank you so much for your attentiveness. And I really hope that you really understood. It's only the three ways that I've summed up my message today. Let us go back to the basics in our walk with God. Let us start. Let us get to the starting. It's very easy to apply force on a moving object. Scientifically, it's proven. And let us also observe, or examine our baggage. If we are going to run, what are the things that we are carrying unnecessarily? Those are the three points that I thought today, guys. As we look into this walk, as we look into this hike, we will look into that and do not, found wanting. Do not on the wrong side, or do not be like the rich man when we get to the other side. I like his plea. If you read further, he says, the rich man, he says, Father Abraham, can you now at least send someone down there? I have five brothers who are living like me. He says, I have five brothers. Can you at least go and warn them? And Abraham says to him, if they did not listen to Moses, who's there, they cannot listen to. So here's the message now. Here we have got a lot of Moses in our midst. And God is saying, if you cannot hear my prophets and the Moses in there, how then are you going to listen to someone who's dead? So here's an opportunity for us to listen to the God that have placed in our midst to direct us and not wait for the time when we would be sitting and realizing then, hey, I thought I was walking with God. And there is a word where God is saying, go away. Jesus said, go away, I did not know you. And that is the word that you don't want to hear when you go to heaven. You don't want to realize then that, hey, actually I thought I was walking with Christ, but I was far away from him. So let's make sure that we pay attention to the list. That is the message that I have for you today. And I'm so grateful, gentlemen, for you today, grateful that you have joined, and grateful for the time, and hope to see you again very soon, and hope to walk with you in this journey. Before I leave, I was thinking, or when I was planning the message, I thought of the very same things that the other guys have already said, and just in summary, how do you walk with Christ? One, walk with like-minded people. They've already said it. I like the fact that they mentioned it, walk with like-minded. And those of you who are married, walk with your partners, because you don't want your prayers not to be hindered. It is written as well. So walk with them. The Bible says deal with them as a weaker vessels as well. And those who are working in financials, in the corporate, they realize as well, when you have got a husband and a wife, and you want to make a decision, for as long as you're still speaking to the man and you are not involved in the wife, you are playing around. I was selling a house as well, and I realized as people come in to observe, if it's a woman, a man alone, I look at them as an honor. But if they come together, there's a chance. Or if there's one, at least the lady I know. And the person that came and was interested in the house is when the lady came, and then he came in and told the husband to come. And I could tell the husband going in from this room to that room, the lady have spoken. You cannot afford not to walk with those people. Walk with them with love. Treat them with love is another thing. But lastly, let's walk with God. Let's hear what God is saying. Let us spend time in prayer. Let us invest our time with God. And gentlemen, that's my message to you. Hallelujah. Thank you.